eso aquí en Auto 060 y vamos a hablar ahora de las nuevas pruebas de impacto que hace el Instituto de Aseguradoras. We're going to switch back to English because we're talking with David Subi. He's the Chief Research Officer for the Institute of Insurance and Highway Safety. How are you, David?
I'm good today. How are you, Javier?
Thank you very much. Yeah, very good. Thank you. Very impressive results in this new test for small cars. Very impressive. Can you explain first a little bit how is this test done? Because this is pretty recent, right? You started doing it, I believe, last year?
Right. This is a new crash test from our organization. We started these tests last year. And it consists of running a vehicle at 40 miles an hour into a rigid barrier with only a small sliver of the front end hitting the barrier. This represents serious crashes that occur out there on the roads, and we're trying to improve vehicle designs to do a better job at protecting people.
And produces the change into doing like a full frontal impact to this side frontal impact?
So very few frontal crashes out on real roads involve a completely full frontal impact. Most of them include some degree of overlap or offset. This test is an extreme level of offset, and it's based on research that we did that showed even though cars do a good job of protecting people in full overlap crashes and moderate overlap crashes, they're not doing such a good job of protecting people in the small overlap.
Yeah, and these replicate something that would happen if you, for example, hit a tree or a pole or some utility pole or something like that, right?
Yeah, it could represent hitting a tree or a pole or another vehicle. One way to think about these crashes is they're frontal crashes that almost didn't happen. Because if one driver had moved a little bit more to one side or the other, there would be a miss.
And we're talking about an impact at a speed of 40 miles per hour, which for some people might not sound like a lot, but it causes a lot of damage to the car and to the people inside the car, right?
That's correct. 40 miles an hour is a quite severe crash. We drive on roads at higher speeds than that, but by the time vehicles impact each other or impact trees, they're often going slower than the speed they were traveling before the crash.
Okay, great. So let's go into the details of the latest study. And I guess the Honda Civic got pretty good results.
Yep, Honda Civic is the best performer in this group. Both the two-door and four-door variants earned a rating of good, which is the highest rating we assign.
And that's only in this test, or that's like consistent of the other tests, like frontal, side, rear impact? Or this is only concerning this side impact test?
Okay, so it's good in this new small overlap frontal crash test, but it's also good in our older moderate overlap crash test, our side impact crash test, our roof strength test, and our rear crash test. And as a result of being good in all of those tests, the Honda Civic is one of our top Safety Pick Plus vehicles.
Yeah, and you said you start doing these kind of tests a year ago, and this is like, I believe, the Ford group of cars that you have tested?
Right, this is the fourth group. We started with mid-sized luxury cars, things like Volvo S60 and BMW 3 Series. Then we did less expensive mid-sized cars. Then we moved to small SUVs like Honda CR-Vs and so forth, and now we're testing the small car segment.
Yeah, okay. And in this small car segment, I see the Honda Civic, and then there are mentions also to the Dodge Dart, the new Ford Focus, the Hyundai Elantra, and the Scion TC. Can you elaborate a little bit on the results on those vehicles, please?
Correct. In the small overlap crash test, the four vehicles you just named, the Dart, the Focus, the Elantra, and the TC, aren't quite as good as the Honda, but they have equally good results in our older tests. And so they also are named top Safety Pick Pluses and cars that we would recommend people who are interested in a safe car take a look at.
Yeah, and can you elaborate a little bit in the difference, like why they're not so good in this particular test?
In some cases, we've got indication of injury risk based on measurements in the dummy in these vehicles. In other cases, we see that seatbelts or airbags not quite doing optimal job of protecting the occupants. In some cases, the dummy slides off the airbag, you know, which could happen to a human being, or the seatbelt allows a little bit too much play, and the dummy gets close to structures that could hurt it. So they're doing pretty good, but not as good as the Honda because of these little problems.
Yeah, and then also the Kia Forte, I guess it didn't get very good ratings, right?
Yeah, unfortunately, the brand new Kia Forte is the worst rated vehicle among this group. Its structure collapsed, and we had a lot of problems with the seatbelts and airbags, and we measured high forces on both the dummy's legs. So it doesn't measure up against the other vehicles in this group.
And those were the potential of the replication of the injuries, like basically the legs or some other parts of the dummy?
Oh, yeah. There are indication of leg injuries and indication of a head injury. In addition to the fact that the structure just doesn't hold up, the dummy is feeling the inadequacies of the vehicle as well.
Yeah. We're talking to David Subi. He is the Chief Research Officer at the Institute of Insurance and Highway Safety. And David, can we talk a little bit about the dummy? Because, I mean, like the tests have changed. What about the dummy? The dummies have changed also. I mean, like, does this take into account, for example, the size of the average driver in the States? What about male, female, child, and all those things?
So the dummy that we're using these tests represents an average size male adult. Now, he was developed back when the average size male adult wasn't quite as heavy as we are today. But he's still pretty good representation of, you know, the sort of middle of the population. There are other tests that we do, like our side impact test uses a small female dummy. So we are covering a range of occupant sizes when we do these tests. There haven't been big changes in the shapes or size of the dummies to reflect the changing population.
And what is the average size of the population? I mean, what is it's been used for this?
So this dummy is about 5 foot 10 inches tall and weighs about 170 pounds. I believe the average American is a little bit taller and a little bit heavier than that.
Yeah. And do you have oversized dummies for other kind of tests?
We do have oversized dummies for other types of tests, but in this case, we chose to use the average-sized one.
Yeah. Let's go back to the results of these compact segment cars. The Chevrolet Sonic had some mixed results, I guess?
Yeah, the Chevrolet Sonic rates marginal overall, and it's got a pretty good structure, but we saw some serious indications that the seatbelts and airbags weren't quite doing a good job of protecting people in this type of crash. And we also had a fairly high risk of leg injuries measured.
Yeah. How many cars did you tested for this segment? I mean, is this like a one-shot thing when you crash the cars? Because, I mean, you guys buy the cars, right? I mean, you only have like one shot of doing the test and getting it right?
That's correct. We buy all of these cars at local dealerships, just like people do when they go out to buy a new car. And we do one test. And so running the test correctly and precisely is an important part of the work we do. We haven't tested the entire small car segment here, but we've hit the most popular models from each automaker. And sometime in the future, we'll round out that group with some more tests of small cars.
Yeah. So the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety, can you explain a little bit what is this exactly? I mean, this is a group of an independent group, a nonprofit organization, right?
Yes, Insurance Institute for Highway Safety is independent and nonprofit. We get our funding from insurance companies. Our sponsors are interested in making the world a safer place, and one of the things they do to help that is fund the research that we do in terms of making vehicles safer, trying to make roads safer, and pass laws that keep us all safe.
And the manufacturers actually pay a lot of attention to your tests because they actually do their own tests, I believe. And like when you come up with your own results, they, in some cases, or maybe in all the cases when it's possible for them, I guess, they modify the way they build cars, right? And they adapt new technologies and new features in the cars to make them safer after your results.
Yeah, that's exactly right. We're talking with the automakers all the time as we develop new tests, so they know what we think the new problems out there on the roads are. And, you know, manufacturers are looking for solutions to those problems. Some manufacturers like Honda and Chrysler and Ford and Hyundai with their Elantra in this case are ahead of their competitors. But all the manufacturers have told us that they're working on solutions to this problem, and we expect to see the results of these tests get better with time.
Excellent. Thank you very much, David Suvi. He's the Chief Research Officer for the Institute of Insurance and Highway Safety. And there's an internet page, a web page where people can look at these results. Is this public information?
You can find our results at www.iihs.org.
Excellent. Thank you very much, David. And people should drive safely despite of the car they're driving. And some are better than others, but like the main factor is still the human being, right?
Right. Yeah. Thanks very much for allowing us the opportunity to talk about our results with your audience.
Thank you very much. Era David Suvi, es el jefe de investigación del Instituto de Aseguradores y Seguridad en las Carreteras, que han probado la cuarta ronda de pruebas en vehículos compactos con la nueva prueba que hacen del impacto frontal, pero parcial. Solamente el 25% de la parte frontal del vehículo impacta una barrera de 5 pies. Es una barrera sólida que representa lo que sucedería cuando se impacta, digamos, un árbol o un poste de la electricidad, y según los resultados que han visto ellos, según las estadísticas que han visto en sus resultados, esta es la mayoría de los accidentes que casi no pasan, pero que pueden ser fatales. Así que revisen la página iihs.org para que vean todos los resultados. Esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota y regresamos más en esta edición.